Okay, now we will explain electronics. Sorry, lecture for electronics for English students. We will continue the circuit terminologies or basic circuit elements in electronics circuits. For this lecture, we will talk about resistor in series. This figure shows the three resistances are connected in series. How can I know that these resistances are connected in series? Each component in the circuit has R1 and R2, sorry, has start and end. R1 will connect to R2 from one end, only one end, and the second end will not be connected to R2. For R2, it will connect to R3 with one end. Okay, so to define the resistors to be in series, R1 will be connected to R2 using only one end. It will this end will not be connected to R2. Okay. And this end will be connected to R2. Yani R1 has one end, one start and end. R1 will be connected to R2 using the end only. Will not be connected it by the start. Okay, it will be connected by the end only. R2 will have start and end. R2 will be connected to R3 from its end only. Okay? R3 will not be connected, will not be connected to R2 from the start, will be connected using an end only, from one terminal only. Okay, this is the definition of series resistors. There is some rule called the voltage division rule, which is related to the resistors in series. What is the main goal of this rule? This rule intends to get the unknown voltage value of a resistor in series. Voltage division rule tends to get the voltage value of a resistor in series. Okay, what is the rule to get this unknown value? To get V1, which is the voltage around R1, V1 equal R1 over R1 plus R2 plus R3 multiplied by V source. Okay? So V1 will be R1 over R1 plus R2 plus R3 multiplied by the value of V source. And so on for V2. V2 will equal to R2 over R1 plus R2 plus R3 multiplied by V source. You can notice that to get the voltage V1, the numerator will be R1. To get the voltage V2, the numerator will be R2. To get the voltage V3, the numerator will be R3. What about the denominator? The numerator will be the summation of all resistances in series that the voltage is divided on. The denominator will be the resistances, the summation of resistances in series at which the voltage is divided. Okay? As we know that the voltage is divided in series, so the voltage will be divided on R1, R2, and R3. So I will do summation for R1, R2, and R3. Okay? So to get V1 using voltage division rule, I will put on the numerator R1 and the denominator R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then I will multiply this quantity by the voltage source value. Okay? This is the voltage division rule. So if I have this circuit that have resistances in series, I can use one of two rules, voltage division rule or KVL, to get V1, which is the voltage of a resistor R1, which is a series with R2 and series with R3. I can use voltage division rule or KVL. Okay? So, if I would like to get V1 using KVL, what will I do? I will apply KVL in this loop, which states that I assume current direction and see and do the summation of all voltage in this loop, V1 plus V3 plus V2 minus V source equals 0 minus V source, since this current direction will enter this terminal in the negative terminal. So I apply the KVL such that I get equation positive V1 plus V2 plus V3 minus V source equals 0. Then I go on in the process of answering. To apply the voltage division rule, I get V1 by using the just mentioned rule, V1 equal R1 over R1 plus R2 plus R3 multiplied by LV source. Okay, so the straightforward method, if I have resistor in series, is to use KVL or voltage division rule. Okay. Then we will take the resistor in parallel. This figure shows three resistances in parallel. How can I know that these resistances are connected in parallel? As I mentioned before, any resistance has two terminal, start and end. Okay. So for R1 it has a start and end, and for R2 it has a start and end. To connect R1 and R2 in parallel, it will R1 and R2 will connected from their start terminal, and they will be connected from their end terminal. So they will be connected from the two terminals. If the two resistances are connected from the two terminals, the start with the start and the end with the end, so these resistances are called resistors. Are called parallel. Sorry. And so on for R2 and R3. R3 has start and R has end. So the end is connected to end with R2, and the start is connected to start. As shown, so these resistances are called parallel. This is the resistor in parallel. For the resistor in parallel, there is a current division rule. Current division rule. Current division rule states that to get a current value on a resistance in parallel, you have to multiply G1 divide G1 by G1 plus G2 plus G3 multiply this all this quantity by the current source. Okay. Current division rule is a rule that is used for resistor in parallel. It states that to get a known current value for a resistance R in a parallel with other resistances, you have to follow this rule. I1 equal J1 G1 over G1 plus G2 plus G3. This terminal is multiplied by I source, okay? And so on to get I2. I2 will be G2 over G1 plus G2 plus G3 multiplied by I source. And so on for I3. I3 also will be multiplied by I source. Okay. What is J1? What is J1 and J2 and J3? J1 is the J is the conductance, which is the one over J equal one over R. J equal one over R. To get I1, you have to divide one over R in the numerator, and the numerator will be 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. Okay, this is the R I1. Then you will multiply this quantity by I source. Okay, this is voltage division rule. So if I have resistances in parallel, the straightforward method that I should follow is the voltage division rule or the KCL to get the unknown current value in the circuit. If it asks you to get I1, you have to use current division rule, which states that in I1 equal J1. I will not write it. I1 equal J1 over J1 plus J2 plus J3 multiplied by I source. Okay. Using the voltage current division rule, you get the unknown current value. Using the KCL, you will consider that the all current entering a node equal to the all current out of this node. As can be seen, this node will have the input I source, and we'll have output I1 plus I2 plus I3. This point is the same as this point. So I will have I source, the input current equal to the summation of all currents out of this node, which is I1 plus I2 plus I3. Okay, KCL states that the summation of all current entering a node equals the summation of all current out of this node. So this node, say node A, have entering current I source. The out of this node, the output current of this node is I1 and I2 and I3. Why? Since this point is the same as this point is the same as this point. So this circuit can be converted to this circuit. For more clarification, you have node A and you have this resistance, this resistance, and this resistance. You have here I1, and I1 and I2 and I3, and this is I source. Okay. This circuit can be converted to this circuit. For more clarification, the circuit is this circuit. Okay, since this point is the same as this point is the same as this point, since there is no any internal devices between it, no internal devices between it, so this point is called A, point A, this point is called A, this point is called A. Okay. Uh, So in parallel, in a resistor in parallel, for resistor in parallel, you can, the straightforward method is to use current division rule or KCL rule. For current division rule, it states that I1 equal J1 over J1 plus J2 plus J3 multiplied by a source. For KCL, the current entering a node equals the current out of this node. The current entering this node, which is called A, the current entering is I source, the current out is I1 plus I2 plus I3. This is the current out of node A. Okay? Till now, we explained what is meant by current, voltage, power, and what is the difference between power absorbed and power dissipated. We know the definition of resistor, resistance, and resistivity, and the voltage source and the current source. We know that we have two types of sources, independent sources and dependent sources. The independent sources have circle and explicit value. Say 10, but the independent value, independent sources have diamond shape and explicit value multiplied by variable. It will have, مثلا, say 10 multiplied by variable. Okay. This is a independent source. It's a dependent source. This is a voltage dependent source. This is a current dependent source. If the variable that I multiply by is V, this is a voltage control dependent source. If this variable changes to be I, it will be current controlled current source. Then we explained what is meant by open circuit and the short circuit, and defined that short circuit is a direct wire between two points A and B. With this short circuit has the features of R equal zero and I equal maximum, when I maximum. وطبعا ال V equal zero. For the open circuit, it is a wire between two points A and B, but this wire is broken. This wire is broken in the middle, is open in the middle. So it has zero current, I equal zero, and the resistance, I equal zero, where the resistance equal infinity, where the voltage may have greater than zero. Okay? May have value in the open circuit. Fine. Then we define the branches and the loops, and know that the branches have two definitions, where the nodes, where the mesh is a loop, but a loop is not a mesh. Then we talk about the KCL, the current division rule, and the KVL and voltage division rule. Now we will explain some examples about as a practice on the concepts that we took in this lecture and the previous lecture. In this figure, I have three resistances in series. I have the values of the resistances. It asks you to get V1 and V2 and V3. It asks you to get V1 and V2 and V3 given V source equal 12. As we said before, we have only two straightforward methods to solve this example. Since I have series resistor, so I have to use KVL or voltage division rule. Okay. voltage division rule. In this example, I will solve using KVL. It's okay. You have to use you should يعني, you can use any method. After applying the KVL in this closed loop, I will have this equation minus V source plus V1 plus V2 plus V3 equals 0 plus V1 plus V2 plus V3 equals 0. This is an equation with three variables with three unknown values. I can replace LV1 by using Ohm's law, which says that LV equal I multiplied by LR. So LV1 will be IR1, and LV2 will be equal IR2, and V3 equal IR3. Then I will put V source in the other direction, the other part of the equation. So I will get IR1 IR2 plus IR2 plus IR3 equal V source. I can take I as a common between R1, R2, R3. Then I will substitute by the values R1 and R2 and R3 and V source. This equation has only one unknown value, which is I1. Then after substitution, I will get I1 equal 3. Then I can get the value of V1, which is I equal IR1. The current value is 3, where the resistance value is 1. So the voltage will be 3 multiplied by 1, which is 3. And so on for V2, V2 equal IR2. The current value is 3 and the resistance is 2, so the voltage will be 3 multiplied by 2, which is 6, and so on for V3. You can notice that in the summation of the voltages V1 and V2 and V3 are 3 plus 6 plus 3 will equal to 12, which is the value of the voltage source. So KVL states that the summation of voltages in a closed bus equals to 0, and it states that it has two definitions, and it states that the summation of voltage rise equals summation of voltage drop. So the voltage rise is I have only one source, so the voltage rise is V source is 12, and the summation of voltage drop اللي هو V1 and V2 and V3 equals to also 12. Okay, just to do double check on your answer. V1 and V2 and V3 summation must equal to the V source, since they are three series resistors. This is the answer of this question. You have to answer using any method. For example, I have three parallel resistors. So I have two direct methods, KCL or current division rule. Current division rule. Okay. I will solve using, for example, current division rule. It asks to get I1 and I2 and I3 for I source equal 12 and J equal 1, J2 equal, J2 equal 2, and J3 equal 1. To get I1 using current division rule, I1 will equal to J1 over J2 plus J1 plus J3, and the marker is very slow, multiplied by ال I سورس. ال J1 equal 1, ال J2 plus J3 plus J1 equal 4, 1 plus 2 plus 1, multiplied by ال 12. To do some يعني minimization of the equation, it will, the result will be 3. 3 ampere. So I1 will equal 3. I will do the same process for I2. The I2 will equal to 6 ampere. And I3 will equal to 3 ampere. Okay. This is the answer of this question using current division rule. You can notice from the results that summation of output current I1, I2, and I3 equals to the input current level I source, as KCL rule states, which says that the summation of current entering a node equals summation of current out of this node. This is for to double check only, okay? Again, we will neglect example 3 and example 4. We will answer example 5. This example asks to get the values of IA, IB, and voltage V0, and to get the power dissipated at each resistor and the power delivered at the voltage source. To get the current IA, I will use current division rule. To get the current IB, I will use the current division rule. To get the current division rule, IA will equal to J1 over J1 plus J2 multiplied by I source. Here I said J1 and J2 only. In the previous example, I was having three parallel resistors, so I have J1, J2, J3. In this example, I have only resistor 1 and resistor 2, so I will have J1 and J2 only. Two resistances in parallel, so I will have J1 and J2 only. The value of J1 will be 1 over 20. The value of 1 over J1, J1 one, will be 1 over 20 plus the value of J2 will be 1 over 80. Then I have to multiply by the current source. I have to find the value of the current source. So I have to get IA, I have to use current division rule. Okay, I will use the current division rule. after applying the rule of current division rule on IA, I will need to get I source. I source is the total current, which will be the voltage total over R total. The voltage total is 50 over over V total. Sorry, over R total. What is the R total of this circuit? I have 20 parallel with 80. Okay, and I have the result is series with 4. So R equivalent, R total will equal to 20. The final result will be 20. So to get I resistance, it will be 50 over 50 over 20, which is 2.5. Okay. The answer of this question is shown in the next slide. We will answer. We will get IA using the current division rule. It will be J1 over J1 plus J2. This is the value of J1. This is the value of J2. This is the value of J1 and J2. Then we will multiply by the current source. The current source. We will get it using this method that we get R total first. Okay. Then we get. We would like to get IB. IB will get using the same method. IB will be IB using. I will solve it using the current division rule. Okay. Current division rule, which says that in ID بيساوي G2 over J1 plus J2 طبعا multiplied by the current source. Okay, this is the rule of I base. After substituting by J2, which is 1 over 80, J1 1 over 20, J2 1 over 80, then I will multiply by the current source, which is 2.5. I will get the value of IB, which is 0.5. تمام? In part B, it asks to get the power at any resistor, so I will have to get the power at this terminal, power at this terminal, and the power at this terminal. To get the power, I have three rules. It'll be equal one multiplied by the V, sorry, the I multiplied by the V, or the I square multiplied by R, or the V square over R. Generally speaking, to get the power at a resistor, you have to use one rule that have the resistor. To get the power in a resistor, for you have to use I square R or V square over R. Okay. To save time, asking about the value of I and asking about of the value of V. To get the power, after considering this rule, for example, I will care about the value of I current, okay? And I will have the value of the resistor. So to get the value, to get the value of the power at resistor 4, it will be the current in this resistor will be 4 will equal 4 multiplied by Li square. Will current Li square at this element is 2.5. Why 2.5? Since this is the source current, and this the current is not divided in series. The current source is 2.5. With this resistance is series with the voltage source, so it will have the same current of the voltage source, since the current is not divided in series. Okay, so the B of 4 ohm. The B of 4 ohm will be 4 multiplied by 2.5, and so on for other resistances to get the B of 20. I will have 20 multiplied by the current square in this resistance. Current square is IA. Current that passes in this branch is IA, which is 2 square. Okay, and so on for 20. It will be 20 multiplied by the current at 20 square. Current at 20 square is 80, is IB. Okay, then it asks to get the power at 50 volt. Since it is not a resistance component, I can get the power using the rule B equal I fil V. So the B of 50 volt will equal the I multiplied by the V. The V is 50 and the I is 2.5. Okay, which will be 125. This is the answer of this question. I answered it using the current vision rule. While answering the current vision rule, I should have the I source value. I get it using the R total. Okay, this is for this lecture.